Realm 1, completing clinic requirements at an accelerated pace. If you're worried about finishing your clinic requirements on time, that's going to be a major impediment to your aspirations. Is that because if you don't finish your clinic requirements on time, you might graduate a month late, therefore setting yourself backwards a month? No. If you're worried about finishing your clinic requirements on time, that mental framework can set you back years. Because while you are frantically scrambling at the last minute to finish requirements each semester, complaining to your friends about how you don't have enough crowns or can't find another canal for endo, there's another student in your class who is vigilantly planning their future success, not worried about these requirements in the least. The reason that that student is not worried about requirements is not because they have no intention of completing them, but rather because that student has executed a time management plan which has allowed them to easily be on top of, and even ahead of, many of the clinic requirements. So not only is this high performer at the top of the clinic, they also have time to focus on the big picture. So let's get into three actionable time management methods to help you finish your clinic requirements with plenty of time left over. Keep in mind, each dental school has slightly different rules for their clinics, and you may have to accommodate these recommendations to your own school's dogma. 1. Get fast clinically. 2. Learn the trading and networking ladders. 3. Begin with the end in mind. Get fast clinically. You can't finish your clinic requirements in a timely manner if you are clinically slow. This means you need to not only be fast at drilling, filling, and scaling, but also fast with your diagnosis and the laborious maze of paperwork that your dental school is undoubtedly having you complete for each patient. So how do you get fast clinically? Take advantage of your sim lab and typodonts. This goes for the first year students all the way up to the fourth year students. Your instructors are going to drill quality into your head constantly, pun intended. So in theory, the quality work will come naturally, but speed? Not so much. It isn't uncommon to have 2 or 3 hour time slots in sim lab and clinic to do a single filling. If you don't push yourself, it is easy to graduate having never done more than one filling in a 3 hour period at some dental schools. Totally impractical and priming you to struggle at a tortoise pace once you graduate. So when you are practicing after hours, during lunch breaks, and on days off with your typodont, work on speed. Even if your preps look like crap, push yourself and see how fast can I prep these plastic teeth. Can I do a crown prep in 5 minutes on this plastic tooth if I really try? 2 minutes if I really, really try? And maybe your first 2 minute plastic tooth crown prep looks like garbage. But then it gets better and better. Something happens during this process. Now your 30 minute crown preps look like works of fine art. And so do your meticulous classmates. Difference being, they took 2 hours to do it. The macro view of this speed is that when you graduate, you can work at a more profitable pace. But the micro view of this is just as important. If you're taking an entire clinic session to complete a single restoration, it's going to take you a long time to meet your clinic requirements in dental school. However, if you can get to the point where you can do 3, 4, or 5 restorations per dental school appointment, you will be insanely ahead of most of your classmates in terms of the time it takes you to complete your requirements. And it starts with getting your speed up relentlessly in the sim lab on your typodonts. Learn the networking and trading ladders. When I decided I wanted to get serious about getting efficiently fast at bread and butter dentistry, there was definitely some pushback from certain faculty members. If I approached Dr. ABC in clinic and said, "Hi, Dr. ABC. Today I have a patient in the chair with lots of decay. I'd like to complete a full quad of restorative for him today." Dr. ABC would scoff at me and tell me that's not how we operate around here. And that's true for most students. So what was I left to do? Say okay and keep jeopardizing my future with the potential of being a Neanderthalishly slow dentist? Keep jeopardizing my graduation date and just hope and pray that I finish my requirements on time? Nope. I passed by Dr. A, B, and C and went on over to Dr. XYZ with the same proposition. This time I got a smile and a, "Sure, let's work together on this one." You see, there are going to be some faculty that are on the same page as you, and some that are not. It is your job to network with the clinic faculty and identify the ones who can and will actively help you, trust you, and take an interest in you accomplishing your clinical goals, not treating you like just another can in the assembly line. Oh, by the way, I ended up winning my class's yearly operative dentistry award. As students of the practice biopsy philosophy, we are not people who like to leave things this important up to chance. Where does chance come into play regarding our graduation date? Of course, meeting our graduation requirements for procedures. Working smart and working fast will get you far. However, sometimes the random patient base you are assigned simply does not bear the fruits of treatment, which you need to graduate. AKA, you need to do 20 crowns to graduate, but your patient base only needs 11 crowns. I guess you're graduating late. No. One of your chief responsibilities will be to maintain an open and friendly network with the classmates in your clinic. Most, not all, dental schools allow you to make trades with your classmates in order to complete certain procedures in a timely manner. For example, I'll let you do crowns for two of my patients who need them if you let me do a root canal on your patient who needs one. I've done enough crowns for my requirement, and you've met your endo requirement. This is the way that many dental schools are set up. Don't get lost here. Begin with the end in mind. You need to have your clinical goals, timelines, and requirements all scheduled out. This is something too important to leave up in the air. From the beginning of clinic, you should print out a hard copy of all clinic requirements and post it somewhere visible where you will see it easily every single day, inside your locker, in your kitchen, in your bedroom or bathroom mirror. If you aren't constantly reviewing your clinic requirements, they can sneak up on you fast. Out of sight, out of mind. Now you're scrambling to get things done and hoping you don't graduate late. Now you're worried about getting these requirements done when you should be focused on developing your future career. Probably your future business. I'll say it again. I won my class's yearly operative dentistry award. The chief concept of creating a system to get your clinic requirements done in a timely manner is so that you spend zero time stressing about this. We want to spend zero time stressing about finishing clinic requirements so that we can hone in on the big picture. That's accomplished by consistently doing the methods above. Putting in time to plan this out on the front end will free up unimaginable amounts of time for you.